are going to visit a construction site. When you see construction, it means our community is growing. New buildings provide shelter. Here, they are building a parking lot and a baseball stadium.
Before we go on to the site, let's go into the office to learn how they plan for construction before they build.
Hi. Oh, good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Tim Sterling.
Penny.
Hi, Penny. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Good. Well, welcome. I'm glad you guys could join us this morning. Climb right up there. There you go. Okay. So we're going to talk about construction. And construction starts with an idea. Well, you heard of the Florida Marlins, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So they're getting a brand new stadium, right?
Yeah.
So in order to go to the baseball game, everyone needs a place to park, right?
Yes.
Okay. Somebody had that idea. And what happened then is they hired architects and engineers to draw the drawings or the plans for the stadium and the parking garages.
So is the baseball field going to be here or there?
Yeah, so what's going to happen? What you're looking at are elevations. So these are the sides of the parking garages.
Mm-hmm.
And in between the parking garages is the stadium. So if you look up here at this drawing, you can see there are two parking garages on the north side and two parking garages on the south side. And the big building that's in the middle is the stadium. Mm-hmm. Guess how many parking spaces will be in this garage?
100.
Oh, more than that?
1,000.
More than 1,000.
More than 1,000?
105.
Yeah, when we get done with the parking garages and the parking lots, there'll be 6,000 spaces.
Wow.
Can you imagine 6,000 cars here? Okay, we've looked at the planning. Now, are you guys ready to see the construction?
Yes!
All right, let's go.
I'm ready.
I'd like to introduce you to Joe Franco, who's one of our superintendents who's looking after the project.
Hey, good morning, everybody. How you doing? Welcome to the Suffolk Construction here at the Marlins Ballpark. Before we get started, I want to give you guys some safety equipment. Try that on and see if it fits. Does anybody know why we have to have a hard hat? Go ahead, why?
Because if something is going to weigh that really small, in case we bump our heads.
In case you bump your head. Now, we're going to hand out some safety vests, similar to what I'm wearing. And these safety vests, we put them on, if you notice, the bright colors, so people could see us. Some other equipment that I have on that you guys aren't wearing today is I have what they call personal fall protection. And then I take this extra hook right here, and when I'm hooked on to something like this, I can't fall down. This is going to stop me from falling. When would I use this? When I'm up in the air, when I'm working high.
That's right.
Exactly. How about if I was digging a hole?
Yeah.
Yeah, right, because it would keep me from falling into the hole. So the other thing I have on is my work boots. I'm standing on rocks and metal. I might step on a nail, and these work boots help keep us safe.
The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go over and take a look at a vibratory roller.
Dogman, you got a copy?
I come back.
Yeah, hey, can I get you over to the roller? We got a group here. We want to start this roller up for them, please.
Yeah,
10-4. Now, when we start this machine, that drum will shake. In addition to rolling, it's going to shake. And what that's going to do is compact the soil so that we can drive on it. So why don't you guys climb up there and you can stand by the operator seat so you can see what the operator sees when he runs the machine. There you go. Fantastic. Okay. Yep, safety belt. You got it just like in a car. So here we go. Wow. Look at that. See how it rolls? Right. It has big wheels. You can go walk on it now. It's nice and hard. Thank you for the demonstration. The next thing we're going to learn is how to hammer nails. And Joe's going to show us how to do that safely. And Joe, do you want to talk to us about what we need to have here?
The first thing I'd like to do is get you guys a nail apron and a hammer holder. So maybe you can help him put this on.
Sure.
Here, here's a set of goggles, and let's put these on. Okay, so okay. Right now we got on our goggles. The next thing we're going to do is a hammer. Now, can anybody help me decide what is a hammer like this?
No!
No, I don't think so. That's the wood pegs. How about this one here? Is this a good one?
No!
No, that's the metal, right? That's not the wood. How about these hammers?
Yeah.
All right, so yes. Everybody pick a hammer. You? I got a hammer too.
Wow.
Okay.
So the most important thing that we have to remember when we're hammering a nail is to get the nail set and then move our fingers away. And then I'm just going to hit the nail nice and easy. I don't have to hit it so hard, make it go in one shot. And I'm just going to keep on hitting it until it goes all the way in. You think you can do that?
Yeah.
Anybody want to try that?
Me.
That's a nail. That's a nail.
Very good. So there you go. You just take that and straighten it up.
Very good.
Excellent. Let's go over here and we're going to do some digging.
Okay, I want you to take your shovel, push it into the pile of rock, and I want to take your dirt and move it over here.
Yep. Keep digging the rock.
Ooh, how tall do you think it is now?
Maybe.
It's tall. Do you think it's almost as tall as your knee? It's definitely up to your shin.
Well, we'll dig and we'll make a little bigger pile.
Let's make a bigger pile. Let's make it taller. Good. It's getting taller. Come over and let's measure it next to your feet. Wow, it's getting taller. It's almost all the way up to your knee.
Okay, here we go. That's good for the digging. You guys did a great job. Look at that big pile that you made. That's a big truck in there. You see that? Now, if you remember on the other side where they were moving all the dirt, remember that from this morning? This side used to look just like that. Now we're actually building the building up from the foundations. That surface those guys are making up there is where you're going to drive your car when you come to the Marlins, the Florida Marlins ballgame. And what that crane's doing is that's helping these guys lift those forms. And that is what they use to tilt these walls into place. So all these walls, you see those orange braces that are coming down? Those brace the walls to hold the building together.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Happy to have you. It was nice to meet all of you. You did a great job today.
Thank you.
Very good workers. Glad to have you.